follows the lives of four women who live in a time much like our own in Oregon in the U.S. And the only difference between their world and our world is that abortion has been banned again, and there are some other rules, kind of family values rules, that are also constricting women's ability to make choices about their lives. And so the four women are very different, but one of the central questions is about kind of how to live and how to live under the pressure of certain kind of expectations based on gender. Because there's a fifth character who one of the main characters is writing a biography of, and she is a polar explorer who lived in the 19th century. And one of the reasons I wanted her to be in the book was to give a sort of broader feeling of, you know, women's adventures, but also women's sort of the limitations placed on them because of things like being able to, you know, carry a child or not carry a child, and questions around motherhood, maybe the choice not to become a mother, because I think that's really important to talk about too. And so the novel kind of goes back and forth among these different perspectives, and I think of it as a braid, like a rope with, you know, five strands braided together. The teacher you mentioned, she's a woman in her early 40s. She's very happily single, not in a relationship, but she wants to become a mother. And so she's been trying to get pregnant on her own with sperm that she buys on the internet. And one of the consequences of the new laws is that single women won't be allowed to adopt children. And so she can't get pregnant. She doesn't really have any way to become a mother. And then there's also a woman who lives in the woods, and she's a healer, and she treats a lot of patients who can't afford healthcare, or can't afford to go to the doctor. And her character is meant to really bring into the book this sort of longer history of not just the persecution of powerful women and calling them witches, but this question of different kinds of knowledge of healing, medicine, plants, midwifery, that aren't considered valid by the sort of people in power. And so I've long been interested in witches and kind of how, not just the figure of the witch, but how people, how it raises anxiety in a society. Yeah. I started writing the book before I moved to Oregon, and I was imagining it taking place on the East Coast of the United States. But when I moved to Oregon, I remembered that the capital of Oregon is Salem. And so it was just perfect, you know. So there's this coast, you know, the seacoast where it takes place, but then the idea of Salem, because that word really carries the baggage of the Salem witch trials. And in the first draft of this book, I used actual language from the Salem witch trials in the courtroom scenes with the mender. And later I took it out, but it was really fun to do that research. Yeah, there's a book, and I believe it's going to be translated into French, but it just came out in Canada, called Women Talking, and it's by a Canadian writer named Miriam Taves, T-O-E-W-S, and it's based on a real-life sort of horror, which was there's a colony in Bolivia of people, Mennonites, who it's like a sort of subset of Christianity, and in this colony, the men of the colony were drugging and raping the women at night, but then denying that they were doing it. And so the book is based on that actual experience. And this happened in 2005. I mean, it's not old. And what is so wondrous about the book is it's really an examination of patriarchy that applies to all of us, not just this small colony in Bolivia. So I'm not sure when it's coming out in France, but I highly recommend it.